What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the video. So today, as you've already judged by the title, we are doing a how-to on my solo trap, aka I'm going to be showing you how to build up my solo trap, which is free to play. As you guys can see, I still have the first purchase bonus if I were ever to buy a pack. Okay, so with that out of the way, let's actually get into the actual overview. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with my heroes. I use the best free-to-play wall heroes you can have: Rose Knight, Demon Slayer, Bombing Goblin, Child of Light, Snow Queen, and Oathkeeper. I know that's six of them, and here is what I actually use on my wall. It is optional, but I always recommend using the Rose Knight and the Bombing Goblin, as they give army attack stats, which is what you need, basically. Then you can choose to have two infantry, two range heroes, or two cavalry heroes. It all depends on you guys. I personally go with this setup. I feel like it's better and works better for my trap. Next, for the familiars, I use the best free to play ones you can get, and that's Aquarius, that reduces the enemy's army HP, and of course the Evil Weevil, that increases my army HP. Guys, these wall heroes and familiars are completely the best, so just, you know, level them up and get them into your wall as soon as possible. Next, we have my building setup. I do have a barrack in the manor to level 25, and the rest infirmaries, which gives me 618,000. It should be 600,000, but it's 618,000, and I will explain in a second. But I will not be deleting those for infirmaries, because I still do not wanna. I still wanna have a level 25 of each building, so I can eventually turn my account into a T4 account, which actually is the plan. So next, I am also a stone hyper. I do hyper for my guild. I currently have 1.15 million production per hour, which is solid. So I do hyper for my guild and help them out, and these are my familiar buildings. We will take a look into the familiars a bit later on, but this is just a small glimpse. Next, for my troop composition, I currently have 15.3 million troops, as you guys can see. I do not have the 20,000 of each D3 anymore. I deleted them. That was 2 million unnecessary might. They were absolutely no use. And this is what my composition looks like. Okay, so now that we are looking at it, I do not recommend you guys copy it. I would recommend you guys go for the infantry I have, and then 2.5 million cavalry instead of T1 cavalry. The reason being is because you can then switch your phalanx, which basically allows you to cap easier. You know, you can kind of take a cavalry hit into cavalry phalanx if you do manage to switch in time instead of an infantry, which will give you a lot of reds. If you guys have seen my latest solo trapping video, you guys know that cavalry does absolutely blast you into Netherland. But yeah, just build up 2.5 to 3 million of T2 infantry and 2.5 to 3 million T2 cav, or you can go with range instead of cav, it's up to you. And then the remaining T1, just go between 6 to 8 million. Maximum of 8 million, because that is the troop limit, well, troop cap you can have. It was tested by Sneakitashi and Aloha, the guy that has the 616 trap. And next, have a few of those ballistas just in case, you know, they can prevent siege walkbacks, so they will never hurt you. What should I show you next? We can take a look into my research, sure. Okay, so for the economy, I recommend you guys only work on the construction speed. You can get it to level 10. It's up to you to which level you actually want to get it to. You don't even have to work on it at all, but I personally did, because you know, just 70% is actually a lot, so it helps me out. I also did this research because, as I said, this account is eventually going to be T4 account. But guys, do not do this research. It's a lot of might. It's probably over 10 million might. I actually do not know how much it is, but I would say it's close to 10 million, so do not do it. Defense, I did it. You shouldn't, nobody should, because it's absolutely useless. You don't need any traps, they just get destroyed. They are irrelevant in a fight. Military, maxed out for Academy 24 and for Castle 24. But if you have your Castle at 25 and Academy 25, you should max this out. Look at the amount of stats you get for level 10, from 9 to 10, which is 48% on the army HP, on the defense, which is not really anything but army attack, so that's actually very useful. Plus, you get more HP on your troops if you do have it at level 10, which is also very helpful. The less damage you take, the more you deal. Monster hunt, you don't have to do it. I did a bit just so I can hunt. I overdid it, honestly, but, you know, it is what it is. Upgrade defenses, as the same as defense, do not touch it. I didn't. I was smart enough not to, and I'm actually proud of myself for that. But Let's just continue on going to upgrade military. Of course, you would want to have two of your quick swaps unlocked so you can switch from your real to fake gear. And I also did subsidies for my troops because RSS are very, very impactful in traps or just Lord's Member in general, and having to heal from your bags every single time, it's costly. So the less I have to spend on healing, the better it is for me. Army leadership, you honestly shouldn't do much, just unlock the cavalry phalanx and range phalanx. I did this for no reason, I was just, you know, hoping to get more bed infirmary space, which this is absolutely nothing, and upgrading it to level 5 is a lot of might, and then to level 10 is even more for absolutely no percent. Next we have the military command, do this minimum research for breakthrough. It is all the previous researches to level 1 and that's it, then you can do the breakthrough. Next we have the familiars. I personally recommend you guys get pack 3s. All of the previous researches you have to do be level 5, so you can actually unlock pack 3s and then you should be fine. Next we have familiar battles. I did minimum for my familiar battle slot 2. This is what it has to look like if you're going to be doing it, which I recommend you guys do it. It's not a lot of might, but it's very helpful in attacks and defenses. Sigils, I did not touch because it's a pay-to-play research, wonder battles as well, and the gear, of course, it's locked. Okay, so next we have... Oh yeah, familiars, okay. So here is what my familiars look like. I've been working on them for a few months now. I've had this max for a while. I did max this out because it regains my energy a bit faster, but I basically did it just because of this fresh air ability. 20,000 random tier 1 troops is not that bad, but when you do get what you do not need, it's kind of wasteful, but you know, I did it, you shouldn't, honestly. And his army talent isn't good for traps because 10% of your troops have to die for it to activate, which is absolutely not worth it. That's like 1.5 million of my troops have to die in order for it to activate, which never happens, let's be honest. Evil Weevil, of course, we did it for the army talent, and plus I did this get around skill because it's free and it doesn't cost me any might. Next we have the Aquarius, which everybody gets, and you should too. Refreshed ability is very important for getting your heroes maxed out as soon as possible, and then the army talent that is the most valid of the Aquarius familiar. Strix, I did it, you shouldn't. This is completely wasteful, it doesn't really help much at all. Even though it's 70.5%, it's absolutely nothing, but I did it, you shouldn't, and its ability is not that good either. Next we have the Trickster. Here is the reason I unlocked pack 3s. It's for the attack. At level 10 it gives 10%, which is absolutely nice, and I really use any percent I can get. And then plus Lucky Star's ability is very useful for, well, basically Guildfest and just the Labyrinth in general. Small Shaman, I do have infirmary capacity level 7 at the moment, which is also basically the reason I unlocked them, and plus the infantry attack that I get as well at 10% at level 10. So at the moment it's 5, but it will be leveled up surely. So infirmary capacity and infantry attack, very useful familiar, get it to level 60, get it maxed as soon as possible. Next we have Noceros. We unlocked it because of the cavalry attack, and once it's level 60, you can also use the in a flash skill. It's good for Noceros trapping, and you can get some leads this way as well. So guys, you can set up a few smart traps with this. So just basically unlock the Noceros as well, max out the cavalry attack ability, and you should be good to go. Rest are irrelevant, you shouldn't work on them, you shouldn't upgrade them, nothing. There we go. Next, my gear, which is basically the last part of this video. Gear is basically depending on what type of player you are. For me, I will also explain my gear choices and stuff, and I will also give recommendations to what you should build as a what tier spender you actually are. So let's just really quickly go through my cabinet. As you can see, just regular fleet to play pieces, nothing too special. And there's also some fake gear I used and some monster hunting gear that I actually got through Guildfest. But nothing special, here's my jewels, a bit extra, but I'm working on getting my purple at the moment. Okay, and so here is what the actual real set of my trap looks like. It gives me almost 100% on each. Each I get 105 on the range, 90 on infantry, and 87 on cavalry. And then the army HP 40%, and then the army attack 4.25. Okay, so gear choices. Why do I have the Tomahawk and not the Greatsword? Why do I have the Scimitar and not the Mitts? Why do I have the Beast Helm and not the Bumble Helm? Why do I have the Carapace and not the Fireball Plate? Okay, so Tomahawk is better if the Greatsword isn't purple or any higher grade. Unless the sword is purple or any higher, you should switch it out for... you should put it in instead of the Tomahawk. Next, Beast Helm. I use Beast Helm because I cannot make my Bumble Helm green, nor can I make it blue. I would love to have at least one of my helmets blue, but it's far away. And the reason I also do not have Bumble Helm is because of my Carapace, which I don't know why I built it, but it is what it is, and I have to stick with it now. But basically, just build the Bumble Helm instead of the Beast Helm. If you do, for some reason, build both of them, Beast Helm is only better if it's higher grade than the Bumble Helm. So here, of course, the Fireball Plate is the best you can go with. It's also the only gear piece you should be really getting as a trap from the Ancient Blueprints, and not the Carapace nor the Hedonic Cuirass, which they are also solid pieces, but they do not really give you army HP, which is basically what we are looking for in traps. So next, you can either use the Dragon's Talons or the Tidal Titan Boots. I personally use the Talons because they're much easier to get, and the Tidal Titans ones are absolutely insane to upgrade. It costs way too much. So that Dragon's Talon, very good gear piece, a lot of HP at max, well, at mythic grade, and also nice attack on range and infantry. Next we have the Scimitar. Scimitar is better than the mitts if the mitts aren't gold or mythic. So mythic or gold mitts are actually better than the mythic scimitar, but if the mythic scimitar is actually better than the purple or lower grade mitts, so use the scimitar instead. And this is what my accessories look like. You guys have already seen them a few times now, but I think everybody should have an Ambrosial Cup. It's an absolute monstrous of a gear piece. It's hard to upgrade, but mine is actually quite close to blue. I should probably work on it through Tycoon, which I think Halos are out right now, so we will see if I'll actually do that. And yeah, you should get the Ambrosial Cup as well. Blue or any higher grade is absolutely fine. I personally have it agreed at the moment because I'm free to play, but you should get it to blue. So Blight Ring, of course, very easy piece to actually obtain and upgrade. Gives a lot of army HP, especially at mythic, which is what we value in solo traps or any type of traps, that is, so you should get it as well. And the last piece I use is the Burning Scroll. It is very underrated gear piece because people think it's not good enough stats, but look at this, 12.6 at mythic grade, which is absolutely not nasty when you think about it. There's three troop types, and each of them gets 12.6 army attack, well, attack and HP. So you should get the Burning Scroll, guys. It's actually a very good piece. I'm working on mine to get it to purple. It's almost, well, it's over halfway there, but it's still some work to be done. But if you're gonna be more than a mid-tier spender, you could probably get the Skull Crusher in here. You could get more than one cup here, and you know, Blight Rings. You can do more combos. You can take a look into other people's gear, like Stu Trap, Chris Churn, Mythic Real Trap, Billy the Trap, and you know, those guys that have basically that spend on the game and on their traps and working on their gear. But guys, thank you for watching. I hope you did enjoy this video, and hopefully you learned how to, well, actually build my solo trap, which is basically the whole point. But thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.